inertia. It is a very basic topic. You have gone through it in class 9th also. The basic thing is, what is inertia? If I keep this marker on my palm, it will remain at rest as far as I am at rest. Or if I keep a body on a table at rest, you know that it will certainly remain at rest unless I am going to remove that body, I am going to move that body, or you are going, or some external agent is going to move that body from its state of rest. Similarly, one thing is also very important. If a body is moving, like if a car is moving, if you just push a toy car, it will continue to move forever. However, it is not the case in real life. When we switch off the engine of a car, it stops. But inertia says, if a body is in motion, is in uniform motion, it will continue to move unless an external force is applied on it to stop that body. So why does it happen? I switch off the car, of engine of the car, it stops after covering some distance. That distance is called stopping distance. It is dependent on few factors that we will study in the chapter. I switch off the engine of the car. Car stops after covering the stopping distance. Why does it stop? Because in real life, an external force, friction, stops the body. So there is an external force. There is an external force which is actually stopping the body. Inertia basically says, now let us combine the two definitions. It is the property of the body. It is the property of the body to resist a change. To resist a change in its state of rest or uniform motion. So natural tendency of the body to resist a change. If it is at rest, want to be at rest. It wants to be at rest. If it is in motion, it wants to be in motion. Unless we are going to disturb its state, right? Important thing is, mass is the measure of inertia of body. Certainly, mass is the measure of inertia of a body. I forgot to bring the duster. I told you, please bring the duster for me. Okay, you said, okay, no problem, sir, I'll help you. One day I forgot to bring my refrigerator or a cupboard. I told you, please bring it for me on the second floor. It is on the ground floor. You totally denied. That is mass. You are not ready to move the cupboard from its state of rest. Mass is the measure of inertia. Similarly, a boy was cycling. You tried to stop him. Hey, where are you going? The next day, a truck was moving. You didn't try to stop it. Same the case. Mass is the measure of inertia. Greater the mass of the body, greater is its tendency to resist the change of state of rest or uniform motion. Let us now see, what are the types of inertia? Types of inertia. First is inertia of rest. Inertia of motion. And third one is inertia of direction. My dear students, inertia of direction is also very important. At this stage, direction is very important for you. You have to study, work hard in a right direction. That was not a joke. So, inertia of rest. I'm not going to define it now. I'm just telling you, body at rest remains at rest. Till when? Till external force is zero. It is the precise definition now. Body at rest remains at rest. Remains at rest till till external force is zero. Similarly, a body in uniform motion, body in motion, body in motion remains in motion till external force is zero. You have a very good example of class 9th. You are sitting on a bus, in a bus, inside a bus. Driver of the bus is a champion. He starts the bus, suddenly you fall backward. If bus starts suddenly, you fall backward. This is because of inertia of rest. When you are sitting on the seat, when the bus starts, your lower part of the body being in contact with the platform, with the surface of the bus, comes in motion immediately. However, it is the natural tendency of your upper part of the body to remain at rest. So you fall backwards. Similarly, we have another example. When a moving bus stops suddenly, you fall forward. The basic thing is that when the bus suddenly stops, lower part of the body comes to rest immediately. However, the upper part of the body wants to move because of inertia of motion. So we fall forward. Now, let us move to inertia of direction. We have completed inertia of rest, inertia of motion. Now, let us move to inertia of direction. It is the natural tendency of a body to move along a straight line path unless some external agent is going to change its direction, right? It is the tendency of a body to move along a straight line path unless an external force changes its direction. Likewise, when we tie a stone to a string and stone is revolved in a circle, so actually we are applying some continuous force through the string. Later on we will study that that force is called tension. We are applying some continuous force to the stone in order to change its direction at every moment, at every instant. That is why stone moves in a circle. If somehow the string breaks, now the external force, tension, is gone. Now the external force is gone, so stone will now try to move in a straight line. If the string will break, stone will not continue to move in a circular path. It will fly off tangentially. It will fly off tangentially, right? It will definitely fly off tangentially because it was its natural tendency to travel in a straight line. Similarly, you must have seen the grinding stone. If not in real life, maybe in movies, the grinding stone is used to sharpen a knife. So the person keeps a knife here. It is basically a gear with sharp edges. The motor rotates it. We can also use the cycle for that. The sparks are produced and sparks fly off tangentially because no external force is acting on the spark and it is their natural tendency to fly off tangentially. This is basically inertia of direction. You have to apply a force to change the direction of the body, move a body at rest, or stop a moving body. Now we are in a condition to study Newton's first law of motion. It basically defines inertia. It basically combines inertia of rest and inertia of motion. So it is more popularly also called law of inertia.